Okay. 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 Okay, so it's working. We'll try that again and see if that's any better. Okay, so we are going to try a new game. I don't know how long I'm gonna run here, but we'll see. This is a game that I have had recommended to me a number of times by a number of people. And I've just never played it. I mean, I guess I can't really say that. I've probably loaded or started a game and played for like 10 minutes or something like that. Maybe half an hour. I don't know. I guess we may see if I have the option to load or whatnot. We'll see what comes up here. Let's see what we got. So I guess that's fine. Let's do it. Good enough. Now what do I got for options here? Okay. Alright, so I hear that this game is spectacular. Like, it's one of the best games of the franchise. I have to say that the opening music is pretty solid, so that's always a good sign, right? I mean, sometimes you start a game and it's like the music is, you know, not very good to start with, so that's not a good starting point, but we'll see. It's an older one, so that's not necessarily bad, it's just that a lot of the quality of life aspects of the game. So can I just like go start the game, or do you have to go through this whole thing here, or what? I don't think I selected it to start new game or anything. What is going on here? Oh, this looks like we're just watching a cutscene, okay. Alright, so this is the Cecil character, looks like. And based on his armor, he looks like some sort of knight, and then based on his attack, he looks like some sort of mage, so like some kind of battle mage. So can I just like click the option to play a new game or what? Or is that just like automatic? What the hell's going on here? Is this still just okay? Okay. This guy, what's his name? Bagan? Oh, let me see what it says here. Bagan? 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 I don't know. This guy doesn't sound like a... Doesn't sound like a very good fellow here. Sounds like the king may not be the king. After all, either he's been... I don't know, I'm just guessing, but either he's been corrupted or else, you know, he's just an imposter who looks like the king. The package. What are we, drug mules? Good advice. Yeah, that was pretty evident. It's not always easy to do. the movies or whatnot. So I need to go to the northwest. Are there things hidden in clocks? I wasn't asleep. Looks like there's some chests there. I don't see access to them unless that maybe this does look like maybe a switch model. There's a switch here. Aha! Okay. Oh, okay, well, the guy would have just told me that. Okay, alright. For those of us who don't notice differences in the wall, that could be useful. Or if I hadn't noticed it, who knows, you know? Okay, this is his girlfriend, or some chick who really digs him, I guess. Okay, so we are partitioned up here. This seems like a little maze. Okay, well maybe that's gonna be useful. Yeah, it's probably too much to hope for a game this old would have more than one dialogue option for each character. Yeah. I don't see any switches or anything. Yeah, it's doubtful that I'd be able to open out at this point anyway, even if that was a task that I was supposed to accomplish. Alright. I wonder, is there a Sid in every single game or what? Boy, you get an airship right away, huh? That's cool. Or maybe you don't. He has one now. I wonder if that's the girl who has the hot for Cecil. Well, it sounds like we're some pretty good people here, the Red Wings. And it also seems like the king, it doesn't seem like, it's pretty obvious that the king is either good dude gone bad, or he's unwillfully corrupted, or he's just been, you know, I don't know how to put it into words. like, been made a puppet, like Theoden was by Saruman, where he didn't really realize, you know, what he was doing or saying. Or if he did, he was just unable to act on his own. Okay. The plot thickens. Sounds like he's a pretty good dude. This woman comes to his bedchamber. I never went to the other side of the castle. What did I miss out on that? Should we go back and go to the other area of the castle? I feel like... Well, that's pretty advanced for... What is this, 1991, did it say? Not bad. But, to be fair, Final Fantasy games have always prided themselves on their visual, their audio video exceptionalism. And that's just the way they've always been. The monsters at bay, and while the king here is collecting them, all the monsters are, you know, free to roam. All right, let's go. Do we have? Okay. Let's go ahead and save. Okay. Dark Knight and Dragoon. How do I exit? Okay, that's weird. All my buttons are like... Oh, I don't know. They're the original buttons for the system, but at the same time, you know... Okay, that's good. You know, they changed the So they said Northwest is that town. They changed the, so let's go to the Southeast and see what's over here. Not much, but an empty place. Okay, Dragoon. Let's go for, you know, these freaking one-eyed monsters, dude. They are no end of trouble. Oh yeah, that's right, we're gonna have APD here, so we're gonna be, we're gonna definitely, so, I just got done playing a whole lot of Final Fantasy X. And so, you know, there's, you can just play the game at your leisure. Let's see what we have for options here. Magic. Okay, well, he comes pretty well. Stacked. Status. Okay. Form. I don't know what that even means. Oh, okay, I see. Alright. Change. Okay, that's your row. Okay. So if he's gonna be, yeah, we should try to change. Oh, it has to be all or none. I don't like that. Okay, battle speed, let's make that fast. Well, now let's make that slow. And then battle message, fast. Okay, that should be good enough. And, boy, I don't like that we can't... I'd like to put the Dragoon in the back row, and then the Knight on the front row. That sounds really, really good to me, but it seems like I don't have that option. I guess I could just put everybody in the back row. Probably for the best. Because we'll just, I mean, the Dragoon should do no less damage in the back row, and the Knight. Well, let's see what else we have. Cannot use. Alright, well, we'll just. See how this goes. I should really go in and change the buttons. Because they're just not what I would, you know, I want these buttons to be different. For, you know, whatever. Alright, so Dragoon does. I wonder if I can just hold the button in. Oh, looks like I can't, okay. So 17. Dragoon jumps. Oh no, he doesn't? Oh, is there like no option for cursor memorization? Ooh, that kinda sucks. That is poopy. Hey, Chocobo Forest. Can I talk to Chocobos? I can just ride Chocobos, well that's always good. Well, except I won't get any experience. Let's see where all I can go. Looks like I can't go there. Oh, I can go down here. I wonder if I could walk down there if I like that as far as I can go. Would be surprised if there was a monster here though, that like was like more rare monster down this peninsula. But I don't know if it's worth my time to follow a baseless hunch. And then have to walk all the way back up. Alright, so northwest, is there a town? Through a cave? I have to go through a cave. Oh, that seems kinda ambitious to start the game. You'd think it would be like right here or something. Looks like I can't go up the waterfall. So basically my option is to just see if there's a rare monster to fight down here, which I don't think I have a steel command, so that's not probably worth my time. And, well, I guess drops. And that's just a baseless hunch anyway, just because it's out of the way, but it's probably not that advanced of a game where they would do something like that anyway. I mean, this is 1991 after all. Alright, how do I get off my shuttle for though? Oh boy, it's lucky I threw him. I should probably save. Right here. Misty Cave, I see why it's called the Misty Cave. It looks misty. That really sucks that there's like no memory option for the cursor. Yeah, it's probably really not worth doing the jump in here. Let's see what the fighting does. I think one shots and then... yeah, there's not really much point. In the back row. Seems like we're kind of overpowered here. Well... I guess I shouldn't say that. There's probably a boss up here somewhere that will... kick my ass. I'd like to get that chest. I wonder how I get into that chest. That kind of hits pretty hard. What we got for a chest here. Okay, so what do I have for items? I got two cure ones, a clunk, and a package. The drug mule package. That's what I feel like is going on here. The Like, I just felt that that butterfly was, a little bit too beefy. Too beefy looking. Didn't trust it. Yeah, I don't know what I'm gonna do here. It's, the back button is in the wrong spot. I can handle the advanced button being where it's at, but, it's weird. I kind of feel like I missed out on some of the items in the castle there, because I only really looked at the one side of the building. Can I go up here? Yeah, no, I didn't do for a while. I don't know what this is, that something? Can I push that on or anything? I mean, this is the era of Zelda, right? Push rocks and stuff. Heal? It must be like some kind of... healed me of a curse or something? Antidote? Type item? Boy, that Cecil sure likes to miss. Kane, on the other hand, seems to kinda not miss. So I'm kind of concerned here. Should I heal up here? Because it looks like we got, you know, maybe our first boss fight. Let's go ahead and cure Dragoon. Wonder how many points it is. And let's roll the dice on... See, that's weird. So that's the back button, and then... It's like there's two different back buttons. It's very strange. No, it says no. I didn't necessarily want to do that. I finished off Final Fantasy X. Kind of marathon, really. On multiple levels, I've done 4 playthroughs of that game. It's just actually the first one I did was the Lulu as the main. Basically, it was exactly as it sounds, basically. Lulu is the main character of use in the playthrough. And, went pretty well. Then, the next time I did a Waka as the main. That went a lot better than I had anticipated, actually. It went really, really fast. Or, like, he was really, really fast. Like, crazy fast. And then I did a No Sphere Bridge challenge. I didn't use anybody's guide or anything to play through it. I just kind of just did it on my own. That was a lot of fun. I'd never done anything like that before. I'd never done anything like the Waka as the main before either. That was super fun. The No Sphere Grid Challenge was super fun. It was pretty challenging. But, you know, if you know much about the game, it's not that bad, really. You just gotta kind of, I mean, it is what you think it's going to be, which is that Riku is your method through which you can use magic, because you don't really, the only magic you'll have other than her is level 1 elementals through Lulu, and those lose their effectiveness like really early on, like excuse me, by the time you get to I'd say the Thunder Plains, her usefulness is pretty much run its course as far as her magic is concerned. I will say, however, though, that combining Riku's mixes with Lulu's overdrive, so basically combining both of their overdrives, that's a pretty big deal. You can do some pretty good damage there. And then once you get to the Calm Lands, that's kind of when you have to kind of decide what you want to do as far as, you know, how do you want the rest of the game to go, because that's when you can mix and master with Thief Gear. That is when you can well, it's not the first time you get a Vade encounter, but it's right around there. You get those teleport spheres when you're at the desert. And right after the desert is, oh man. Right after the desert is, I should be paying more attention to what I'm doing. Right after the desert is where you go to Babel, and then right after Babel is where you go to the Calm Lands. So, it's, you know, a Vade encounter isn't going to help you, like, drastically if you, like, try to make a weapon or something, like, immediately when you get it. I mean, it might, I guess, depending on what you do, but what I did for that is I went back to the Jose High Road and I built Waka a weapon. So what, can I skip my turn here? Or do I just have to waste it? Is that okay, there we go. So I went and made Waka a petrify weapon. As soon as I had gotten the ability to teach him, wait, no, not even the Spirit Challenge, I didn't have that option. I don't know, like, they all kind of got muddied up a little bit, but, I did go make that weapon. I did not have Mug, which sucked, because then I only had the one thief, which was Riku, and so everything was really slow to cope. But the main key to that one was just basically making sure that you had the elemental resistances, so that when you fought Seymour and Bavel, that you'd be able to survive, because typically, I guess, in my mind, like, you want to have a flush for that battle, and then it, you know, it's not that bad, but you want to have reflect, though. You know, excuse me, because, well, I guess it's possible that there's a rare steel from a monster somewhere that would give you, those star curtains, or whatever it's called. That you can use with the use command to put reflect on a player, or it could be an enemy too, I guess. That that was not something I had available to me. So my plan and what I used to win was to use elemental resistances. So I spent a lot of time stealing. The early part of the game, you have to basically steal rares. Well, there's a couple monsters where you can get a common that's an elemental resistance. I should say, before you get to home, I can only think of one. That wasn't so bad. The only one I can think of where you can get an elemental resistance item that's a common skill is from the Chimera looking thing. It's a three-headed monster that you fight in the Makalania Woods. I should save. Oops. I guess why not? That one actually, the rare is a Lightning Marble, and the common is a. Ice Wind or something? Arctic Wind. That's the ice resistance. Like, immunity. Package opened automatically! Oh, okay, so it's not drugs. Or maybe. Brought this package to burn the bridge. Why? Oh no, that's terrible. Oh no. Callers. Okay, well, let's just see what happens. I'm gonna save. So it looks like we get Earth Elemental now, I'm hoping. let's make a new scene. The buttons are weird in this game. I need to... maybe I'll read now. Before I start the next stream. Yeah, it sucks that I don't have that Dragoon anymore. This is pretty awesome. He's actually, I thought he was better than Cecil. Yeah, Cecil likes to miss. So anyway, my no Sphere challenge went pretty good. Didn't have much in the way of pickups. I had anticipated the Cecil battle, Seymour battle in Gravel, and so I knew when I got there I was gonna die a few times. So once I played a few rounds, I learned a little bit each round, and then I got to the point where I developed a strat that I thought would work, and then it was a good strat, and it worked. So, I got there, and then when I got to the Calm Lands, I basically was like, okay, well, let's try and use this evade encounter on Waka's weapon, because his weapon was Stone Strike, Stone Touch, and there was one open slot on top of that. So that was really, really, really lucky that I got that. That was huge, because then I could use his original weapon and then just put evade encounter on it. So like he just... Oh wait a minute, am I gonna be able to... what now? I'm blinded? I don't have any eye drops. Okay, how am I supposed to do now? Cure? Oh wait, no, damn it, I bet it's heal. What a waste of item. Yeah, I don't know what these things mean. Okay, so I lost. Oh, now he's gonna do it again, I bet. Well, what the hell am I supposed to do then? Does it wear off? Oh, what, you can still hit them when you're blind? So, wow, that was really, really not good. I got a cure 2 out of the deal, but it cost me quite a lot. I think... Was that heal like a remedy? Did I literally just use a remedy? Yeah, I don't know if I like this, man. This two-death desert, I don't know where I'm supposed to go. Desert is usually bad. And I still have the freaking... Oh, dude, that's not good. I still have blind on me. I may have to use a 10. I'm probably gonna have to reset, actually. Well, maybe not. I guess apparently I'm not blinded. I'm just, like, seriously hindered in my sight. Looks like I got like a 1 in 4 chance or something like that to be able to hit. But if he does hit, I guess Cecil likes to miss anyway, from my experience. He doesn't hit very good. It's probably a really good thing that I did put him in the back row, though. I mean, that's, from my perspective, pretty standard in the earlier Final Fantasy series. The defense seems to be a lot more valuable than the offense, unless you have, like, you know, one really beefy dude, you throw him on the front line, throw like berserk on him or something like that, paste him, that kind of thing. You know, he can just kind of tear shit up that way. But anyway, so I put Evade and Counter on him, and then I decided to put Evade and Counter on Riku because I still needed to steal. I gave her Master Thief. Once I got Master Thief on her, that started to pick things up quite a bit. I happened to have an SOS Reflect armor that had dropped for Riku. So combining that with Evade Encounter, that really made a big deal. Just nasty. It seems like tents are kind of like not that super rare, so I'm going to go ahead and use a tent here. So I can maybe, hopefully, I hate to do this, but I can't very well like try and do all this with without any kind of being blind going on. Looks like I lost my blind. Okay, so that's good. But then, of course, I have to fight these guys. Alright, let's go ahead and try and kill the butterflies as fast as we can. I knew the butterflies were bad news. I guess I just felt that way because they look so menacing, you know? They look much larger than all the other enemies that I've encountered, except for like a dragon at the mixed cave. And then they look like they have these eyes on their wings. They just look like these huge, large, menacing creatures. And so I thought that they were, you know, even though it's just a butterfly, I was concerned about them. And as it turns out, rightfully so, with this devastating status effect that they can just do. Come on, Cecil. Dude, do you know, like, a way to, like, not miss all the time, bro? Like, I don't even know, like, who's... Where's the dragon when you need him, you know? That's one thing that they cleaned up in the later versions of Final Fantasy, is there's not a whole lot of missing, you know? If there's missing that's going on, that's for a reason. Come on, dude! The marathon of missing. So, anyway, there we go. So once I got up to... once I got Riku with Reflect on her, the plan was I was going to go up to the top of Mount Gagazet in that cave and steal Star Curtains from the Dark Flan. And I think I did that. And then didn't even need the items, I don't remember for sure. But the teamwork battle at Mount Gagazet wasn't even that bad, man. Like, so... I don't know what the deal is, but there's something about those summons that the way they're strengthless character is more than just Yuna. So I always just thought Yuna was the governor for those things. And I do believe that that's true, but I also learned that there's no way that's the only governor because she had never leveled up, right? Because it's no sphere granted, so... She was like the weakest she ever was in any game I ever played. But my summons were stronger than they ever were in any game I ever played. So, I haven't gone and like done any research or anything to find out exactly what the hell's going on there, but... or nothing substantial, anyway. I haven't like really dug too deep into it to find out what was going on there, but... there must be some other kind of... governor for that, but they were really good. Like, they were the best I've ever had in my summons, and it's not like I was like adding a whole bunch of attributes to them and stuff like that. Like, I didn't really gain that much. I don't know. Anyway, I was able to just kill Seymour with just straight up summons. I didn't even use a overdrive that anybody had. I just killed him with summons, which I had never done that before. Like, I don't know, it was strange. How easy that ended up being. I thought that fight was going to be a lot more challenging than it ended up being, but whatever, it's all good. The biggest challenge, by far, and not even close, was Jeff. That battle was really tough. I had it in mind that maybe I could just get Arn strong enough so that he could, you know, I could use a stamina tablet on him, I'd beef up his hit points as best I could, and then use a stamina tablet on him, like basically give him hit points plus 20, plus 10, plus 5, you know, give him as much hit points as I could, and then put protect on him, and then use a stamina tablet on him, and that hopefully then he would survive Jack's, the overdrive on the first form. I didn't have any hope that worked on the second form, but I had another plan for the second form. But it didn't work. He just would one-shot Arn. With Arn, with a stamina tablet, with hit point gear, he was still only half the strong as required to survive that overdrive by Jack, even on the first floor, let alone the second floor. So, once... Come on, dude! Can you hit? Like, if this game is gonna be like this, where, like, nobody hits for, like, an eternity, forever and ever and ever, I mean, that's not... Dude, like, seriously. Maybe I need a different character that, you know, can hit flying stuff, because this guy does not do that job good. So the Jux battle I almost gave up on. Almost. I had fought him a number of times, and I was like, dude, there's just no way that I'm gonna be able to beat this guy. And so, there were really only two runs that I made at him that were even reasonably, I don't even know if I'd even say successful, but even reasonably, you know, where I got more than a couple rounds in at all, you know? Usually it was like, he goes like two turns and my party's gone. Or three turns, I guess, right? Four turns, maybe? I don't know, he's kicking my ass all over the place. Then I had this other plan, I was like, well, I'll use Iixin, right? Because his defense is good, and maybe I can use Iixin to keep the pagodas at bay, right? And then, you know, once the pagoda, that's the battle right there. If you can beat him without holding the pagodas at bay, then you're probably way too strong, because you're just, nothing that he can do is going to harm you enough to kill you if you can sustain that and not, you know, and not keep the pagodas in check. That's extremely difficult to do. Like, the whole secret of that battle is just neutralize the pagodas, and then you can kind of go to work on him. And I couldn't do that. That was not something that worked. So what I ended up doing is just basically using my summons, and I didn't have all the summons either. I didn't have Anima, I didn't have the sisters, basically because I kind of restricted myself further. I didn't use any celestial weapons, I didn't use the Blitz Ball for anything. I didn't use the Monster Arena, so I was pretty well restricted, and I was thinking, well, my plan was, let's go kill Jack, you know, with these restrictions on, and if I can't, then, you know, maybe I'll have to revisit, dude, we have to fight another, I can't even run away, dude, like, or is there a runaway option? Think so. I don't know. Why? That shouldn't be run. That shouldn't be pause. Why is that pause up there? Well, that's cool. The music plays in the background when you pause it. I don't know why that's pausing. My buttons are probably all jacked up. Maybe they aren't right. Maybe that's the problem. But holding in the right button, I don't know. Well, I can run away, but my buttons are all screwed up. Okay, I'm gonna have to... maybe it would be better if I just did that real quick. Because something's not right there. Why the hell would that button be pause? So I don't know why that was all jacked up. Alright, now let's see. Okay, well that's much better. That's much better. Okay, so maybe my buttons weren't... Maybe this game's buttons aren't shit. Maybe my controller was just shit. And I'm trying to think, why in the hell... Because the last game I played on this was Final Fantasy VI. So, why in the hell would my buttons be... weird. They should not be weird. Let's kill this guy first, I think. If we can. He looks ominous, does he not? And we already know that the sand people weren't causing us too much trouble. Oh, now we're back to missing again. Oh boy. You gotta have some serious patience there with this. I mean, like... this is almost as bad as the Seventh Saga. And don't get me wrong, I love the Seventh Saga. I think that's one of the great gems of the Super Nintendo RPGs. I think probably a lot of people, especially in today's world, just would not have the patience for that game. But honestly, you know, there are things that people can do these days, like speeding the game up and stuff, that would make a lot of the problems with that game go away. It's just really unforgiving, you know, like, if no one's ever played the Seventh Saga, I highly recommend it. But you gotta be aware that it's very brutal. It's very unforgiving. A good rule would be that if you're not just going in there and dominating the monsters, like, so for example, when you enter a dungeon, right? The dungeon is gonna have monsters that are substantially stronger than what was right outside the dungeon. But in addition to that, the boss of the dungeon is going to be overwhelmingly more powerful than the monsters in the dungeon. So, and the dungeons are usually pretty good size, like they take a fair amount of time, and they're pretty challenging to get through. So, if you're having any challenge whatsoever with the monsters that you're fighting outside of the door to the dungeon, don't go. Well, I mean, you could try and go in there, like if you have a save right outside the dungeon. Or actually, I don't think you can save on the map in that game. I think you have to save at town. Yeah, that sounds about right. I'm pretty sure you can't save on the map. So, basically, if you're having any struggles whatsoever, even with the strongest monster outside of the door of the dungeon, level up. Because once you go in that dungeon, it's not going to get any better. It's only going to get worse. And the same thing applies for the monsters in the dungeon before you fight the boss. Because you'll go in there and you'll grind and you'll grind and you'll grind. And you'll be like, okay, I'm all right now, I guess. You know, I can kind of hang. You start to feel a little bit confident about your characters and stuff. And then you get to the boss and you're dead in like 2 rounds. And it's not even close. Like, he just slaughters you. You're lucky if he doesn't one-shot you at that point. So, you really, really, really need to grind out levels in order to be competitive. So the reason why I'm trying to stay on the grass is because in this franchise, in my experience, the grass has, excuse me, the grass has monsters that are more, they're less difficult to deal with. Then, like, say, for example, the desert or the forest. Actually, I should say, I kind of want to find out what's over here. Like, I didn't go over there yet. And I want to see if there's anything over here. Maybe there's like a hut or something, right? You know, I think I made a mistake today. I picked up some Subway after work. But I guess, so, anybody who's been watching any of my streams knows that I quit my job. I guess a little over a week ago now. My last day would have been a week before last Friday. So it's been like a week and a half, close to 2 weeks now. But I did have like I don't even know what I want to call it, because it wasn't really a traditional interview. It was just, I was given an opportunity to go to this place and kind of shadow them and kind of learn a little bit about what they do. It was very, very different than any kind of experience I've had before as far as like an introduction to like a work environment. And that was cool. I mean, the guys were super nice, and it sounds like the cool, you know, it's an industry that I've been kind of wanting to get into for a while, but that it does appear to be kind of difficult to get any kind of like. So every time I try to get a job in this industry, they're like, "Well, I'm sorry, but we're looking for someone with more experience." And it's like, "Well, dude, how can I get experience if no one will give me an opportunity to gain it, you know?" But talking to some of the people there, it sounds like they don't really have a problem with trying to teach people. And they kind of like the idea that, okay, so I think, I don't think I missed anything. Alright. Different layer of mass, I guess. So they have this philosophy, at least in part, maybe not completely, but they're not opposed to the idea anyway, of taking people on that have little or no experience in the field, because, you know, then they don't really have to deal with, you know, somebody that, you know, hey, I know what I'm doing, I don't need to learn your way, not my way, and, you know, I don't need you telling me what to do. Whereas someone who is new, you know, they're a clean slate, so they don't have any kind of preconceived notions of what it should be. They don't have that, you know, childish thing. These aren't their words, these are my words. I know what that's like because I've, you know, been in situations where I've hired people before, and, you know, you hire someone, and, you know, they're like, "Well, you know, at my last job, we did it this way." It's like, okay, well, that's cool, but, you know, you're not there anymore, so this is the way we do it here. And, you know, so obviously we're probably not dealing with the brightest bulb in the box if, like, that's their, if that's their go-to thing, it is, you know, "Well, we used to do it this way at this job that I don't work at anymore." Well, why'd you leave there then? If you liked it so much, well, you know. So, I don't know. Anyway, I think it's really, really cool that I've been given this opportunity, whether it goes anywhere or not. I think it's awesome, and I feel blessed to have the opportunity even to just get my foot in the door. So I guess technically it was work. I mean, I'm not like a hired employee. I'm not on the payroll or anything. I just kind of went there and kind of shadowed them and absorbed information and kind of, you know, did a little bit of this and learned a little bit of that, and it was cool. But how it kind of worked out was, like, the guy who arranged this for me basically just emailed this dude that's here in town today, or he's in town this week, right? The company's gonna be doing work around where I live for like probably the next couple months is what it sounds like. But the guy that was directly there to like kind of be overseeing something or other, or maybe getting everything kind of organized so then it kind of goes on autopilot after that. The guys that are here, you know, they've been doing this for a while, so they know what they're doing. But maybe this other guy just kind of needed to get, you know, the ball rolling or whatnot. Maybe, you know, sign some contracts with some people. I don't know all the details, but he's going to be leaving on, I think, Friday after, you know, work or whatever. Drive up or fly out. I don't know what the details are talking about. So I got to just reach out to the guy that set this thing up for me tomorrow. And the guy that I talked to, who's in charge of the operation there today, so he's going to talk to this other guy. You know, as far as I can tell, he's going to be like, you know, say, hey, everything went really good with the dude and everything, the dude being me. So I just gotta reach out to this other higher up dude. It's a pretty big company. I didn't really realize, you know, they are pretty big and they're working on quite a lot of number of different states, but we'll see. You know, it'd be really cool if I could, you know, get the ball rolling here with this thing. I did. So the thing is, you know, I'm kind of, what I didn't want to happen happened, right? So I got this opportunity, and then like later on, sometime during the day while I'm there, I got this email from a different company that's like, hey, you know, I had applied for a number of different jobs, right, over the last, you know, few weeks. So it's kind of my job was applying for jobs and kind of exercising my body, right? Building my body up and then, you know, applying for jobs. That's and getting, you know, a good, well-rested sleep and, you know, working my body out, resting my body, resting my mind, and looking for work. But in this new brave world, or brave new world, however you want to put it, that we live in, you can do all that stuff from your house. You don't literally have to go anywhere. So long as you have food, you can do everything from home. Assuming you have like a computer and internet and all that stuff, which it's almost like goes without saying in this world that we live in now. But so I got an email from this other company that I'd applied for, which would have a schedule that probably, I don't know. Anyway, it'd be working overnights. I don't know exactly what the schedule would be. I was thinking that might be something that might not be that bad, because I used to work in bars and stuff like that at different points in my life, in industries where, hey, how's it going, dude? I'm just kind of rambling on about my my day-to-day in my life. It's just something I kind of do sometimes. Yeah, that's cool, dude. I suffer from insomnia as well. And one of my methods for helping with that is something I'm putting on the back burner in my life at the moment, just because it's just something I gotta do for the time being. But yeah, that's cool, man. I can't believe I finished that challenge, man. I went into it with the idea that I wanted to do a deathless run and beat the game in one sitting. But I never mentioned the deathless thing because I didn't want to, like, you know, I didn't want to, like, say, hey, yeah, I'm going to do that shit, you know. It was just going to be, like, one of those things that happened, it happened. And honestly, that's the only reason that I kept on going, because if I had died one time after, I don't know what the point was, I suppose after the Thunder Plains, I would have just simply said, okay. Yeah, dude, it was like 29 hours and some odd minutes, I don't know how many minutes. But it was almost 30 hours. I started it at like 3 o'clock, 3:30 or something on Sunday. And I finished it at like 8:30, 9 o'clock, somewhere in that range, on Monday. It was just one big long ass day. I drank a lot of coffee though, man. Like, I was really, really tired at like 7, 8 o'clock in the morning. on Monday, I was like really tired. I don't remember where I was at that time. Maybe like I don't know if I was at the call lines yet or not. But I was really starting to get really tired. But I just was pounding coffee, and then I don't know, sometime like right around noon on Monday, like it was just like the adrenaline must have kicked in, because I don't think I had any more coffee after like 2 o'clock in the afternoon. It was like I got a second wind, which is crazy. I don't know what that looked like. But I think I was just running out of adrenaline, to be honest, because I was up at the top of Mount Megazette by that point, and, you know, I was getting so close, and I still hadn't died yet, and I was just like, oh, dude, I gotta stay alive, man, I just gotta stay alive. I've never played this game before. But I shouldn't say that. I probably started it. I remember starting it once and then getting to that mist cave area. But that's as far as I got. And I've been told by a number of people this is a really good game. Yeah, dude, I did. I just was like, well, I couldn't go to bed because I hadn't died yet, you know? I couldn't just, like, I just had to keep on pushing, like you said, dude. I just had to. And then I was just blessed and was able to win. I was really scared about the Jekt fight, though, man, because I didn't know how that was going to go. Because that fight is always different. Every time I play that game, that fight always plays out a little bit differently, so... You know, the whole thing with that fight is keeping those pagodas in check. If you can do that, then he's not that bad. But if those pagodas are running wild, dude, if you have to be really overpowered to win that fight if those pagodas are running wild. Because you have to have a shit ton of hit points. I mean, you just got to be able to survive everything he throws at you, which is really tough to do. He's just really tough. Probably not gonna catch me trying to pull anything like that again. I haven't stayed up that many hours. Dude, I don't even know. Probably. Oh. ...2008, probably. I think I might be coming up on a boss here, so I want to find out what's going on. What? Seriously? Well, I don't know where the hell I'm supposed to go then. Well, at least I can run away if I want. Yeah, I don't know, man. I've never played this game before. I have no idea where I'm supposed to go. I did sleep for 14 hours that night, though. And then I was still really super tired yesterday. And then I probably slept another, I don't know, 10 hours last night. I still felt kind of tired when I got up today, but I'm starting to feel more normal now. Dude, I don't know what the hell I'm supposed to do here. This guy says turn around, I'm not strong enough to be here. This is the only place I can see where I could go. Fish? Pike? I don't know who made that spread, but that's not what the pike looked like. It's not northern, right? I wonder if being on the back row affects my ability to my accuracy. shouldn't. It should just be my defense. These pikes seem to have covered out. Oh. Yeah, there we go, a crit. Let's see some more of that. Evil shell. Why the evil? What did they do? So I don't know where he went up here. I don't think there's anything up there. Okay, there's water. And how do we get down there? Maybe there's something in the middle of the desert, I guess. That's possible. I never go to the middle of the desert. I went around the edges of the desert. Whoa, that doesn't look like it's a very nice thing. It looks like something that should be stolen from, is what it looks like. But I don't have a steel command. There's something in the middle of the desert that I missed. Oh, there is. There's a town in the middle of the desert. Now let's go save. Kill these guys off first. I feel like that's probably wise. Usually I would go after the officer first or the stronger monster, but I think probably it's best if I just roll these They're not attacking me, so I don't know, they're not very fast. Again, I wish I had a thief in the party. These guys seem like highly eligible for thieving. Okay, so I got a summoner now. Alright, so she has earth attack. That'll make things a little quicker. So I've got 2100 GP. Okay, alright, a carrot? Is there any way to see what these things do? No, not that I'm aware of. That's one thing that sucks about older games, is you don't know what shit is. Or I can buy 1 or 10? What? I guess it's only 50 GP. I should probably buy one. I should probably buy two. At 50 GP, I should probably... No, two is good enough. Life? That must be a Phoenix Down. Okay. And then heal, is that a, that must be a, wow, 10,000 for an ether? That's really high. Heal must be an elixir, or not elixir, a remedy? Yeah, I may as well buy one. And I think I'm good on everything else. So, who is it? Tella? Anna. Okay, Anna ran away. So we need to find Anna. get out of here. Let's see what we got here. A rod, a cap, a leather, and an iron ring. What the hell does an iron ring do? Shadow, 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 and shadow. Okay. So she doesn't have a shield. I don't know what these things do though, you know? An iron ring? What the hell does an iron ring do? I think that's garbage. You can't tell what stuff does. Clothing or leather, okay. Left hand, okay. So, I don't know, that must be a shield. Sell a shield. Maybe it would be weird if the armorer sold a shield, but okay, whatever, we'll see. Oh wow, I got ether. That was $10,000 find right there. Okay, so rod, staff. A staff, can she equip a staff? Is it even worth my time getting a staff? Can she use a bow and arrow? I don't know. That's the kind of thing that you don't know about these games. You don't know what people can equip. She's a caller. So, you know, you don't know what she can work. Okay, alright, let's take a look and see. Alright, so, because I don't have... Looks like our inventory is highly... A carrot takes up one inventory slot. Well... I don't see anything here that I know that I can use, and I don't want to spend the money and then reset, you know what I'm saying? Know what I'm saying? I can't believe I found that $10,000. People just lose 10,000 GP item in a little barrel. Monster called Ant Lion. Okay. Sand Ruby. It is in the lair of the monster called Ant Lion. Okay, well, I have to, otherwise we're not going to be able to cure you, it looks like. So let's go ahead and just put everybody in the back row. She looks like trouble to me. I do remember the dancer job from 5, but I don't remember. What all it was good for. This is pre-5 though. This is 4. Okay. Alright. That's everybody, I think. There's one more building I need to go in. There's that woman there. I don't think I've talked to her. Oh, yeah, I did. She just moved around the training room. When your items get too many to carry, go to the big chocobos and leave items in their care. When it smells like chocobos, use carrot. Big chocobos will surely appear. Where's the chocobo carrot? People with less hit points than a bat by using the change command during the battles. You can change the front and rear row by pushing the left of the control pad, and in turn by pushing the right, you can select parry. Okay. Okay. I see. Okay. Yeah, okay, well, that was still in 10, following those rules. Thank you. see about this whole changing room deal. Looks like they have to both be at the same spot, because... seems like they can only be a change at the same time, but maybe in battle you can shift that. Alright, so... Well, she's only got 30 hit points. This game seems to be having a bit of a slow burn to it.
At least starting off anyway.
I'm gonna see what the temperature is like there. I think I might open the window or something. Oh yeah. It feels warm in here, but it's like 59 degrees outside. It's just absolutely fantastic. Cool the place off a little bit, hopefully, here. Yeah, that's so much bullshit. So, I tried uploading my video to YouTube, but it keeps telling me that it's too long, and their little bullshit thing says you can only upload videos that are less than 12 hours. But there is a one user, I'm sure there's many users, no doubt, that are allowed to upload videos that are 25, 30 hours long. I've seen them. And it pisses me off that I'm being prevented from uploading a video while others have full freedom to do so. So I sent a complaint or a question, whatever you want to call it, but I haven't heard anything back yet. If I don't hear anything back by tomorrow, I will look into finding out who I need to send emails to and hassle their ass so that I can get at least some kind of a answer. Because this is just total bullshit, dude. Ice 1, okay, that's cool. And Cure 1, okay, even more cool. Is there a way to bring a map up on the screen? It doesn't look like that. That kind of sucks. Well, I'm gonna go back in this dungeon. You just shaved my magic. Oh, wrong guy. Well, not only does it hit harder, it's way faster, too. I don't know what to do with this hit point problem. Yeah, now she's up on magic. Hey, what are you doing? Get the balance from there. My cat is acting as though he's got mischievous ideas running through his mind. Isn't that right? Wow, she just keeps learning spells left and right, man. Alright, you gonna let us through now that I have the girl in the party? There we go, that's what I was hoping for. Alright, what kind of abilities does the sage have? A cure 2? Oh, he's got hit points? He got magic points? Exit? Life? Oh wow, this guy is like kick ass. Level 20. What does Blink do? Fire. What's the next one? Or lightning. Fire, ice, and lightning. How the heck am I supposed to get up to there now? Can I climb up the waterfall? Oh, I can. Okay. Iron Ring. I know it's iron, but, I'm a big fan of Norm MacDonald, and he always called it iron, because he always had something funny to say about everything. The iron. Well, that's no good. Back attack is what they... Can I, are we all in the front row? We are all in the front row. Oh, we can change everybody. Okay, so all of us or none of us. I see. I don't like that. Why can't we choose which individual players are in the front row and which ones are in the back row? It makes it look like you should be able to do individual players, but I don't see that happening. You put out there? Is that football? And the football football that I think is good. I can't tell. Oh, there we go. Crit. Alright. We'll take that. And let's go ahead and see if our formation is still intact. Yeah. that's something that I can learn later on. Like the ability to choose individual. See if charm works. But it did work. All right. Now the question is, will he continue attacking himself? He will. Doesn't appear like there's any, I guess parry, I guess, right? Sorry, buddy.
It's okay.
Oh, yes.
You were trying to get up here tonight. At the last minute, you didn't know about it. I'm sorry, I wasn't trying to get back to that. Yeah.
Sometimes, I just move my arm randomly. And if my cat just happens to be preparing a jump to go from the floor up on top of my chair, and I don't see him because it's off to the spine below me. Sometimes I'll just, like, reject his attempt to jump. Like, I'm not trying to do it, but sometimes it just happens. And then he's gotta be thinking, like, what the hell are you? So usually when that happens, I try to grab him right away and give him reassurance that I wasn't attempting to knock him down and that it's fine for me to come up on the chair. I just don't let him come in my room. I don't want him in my bedroom. My ex-wife. Well, this cat didn't live with us. This is my cat, but she had some cats. And she would let them go up and wherever they want to be, and I'm like, dude, you know, with those types of things that I can make up. Like, I got nothing against cats, I got one, but I just don't want them walking around and climbing around by my bed. That's just the way I don't want to be. There's really only one, two rooms in the whole house, three rooms, I guess, technically. Basically three rooms that he's not allowed in. There's my room, there's, I guess if you want to call it an office, it's not really an office, it's more like a storage room, but there's a desk in there that I never do anything at. My computer and my desk are in a different room. And then they're in the inspector's like that. Room with the workbench and stuff in there and tools, and I just don't want him in there. Oh, look at this. So, 1,000 GP, Cure 2, Elixir, freaking Elixir, dude, at this early stage of the game? Wow, that's pretty intense. I wasn't really expecting to find anything there, but, you know, if there is a rule in video games that does seem to apply across all genres, it is check behind the waterfall. That is the rule of video games. At least I would say that. It is a rule. You should always check behind the waterfall. When I was playing Halo Infinite, I checked behind the waterfall, and guess what I found? I found a skull. I think I found all but two of the open world skulls on my own. And I really feel kind of like I got ripped off on one of them, because I searched around that area. I literally got out of the wasp and looked around and searched around, and somehow I didn't find that one, even though I was there multiple times, and I still didn't find it, so that one kind of pissed me off. But the one on the northwest corner, it's down, well, it's underneath the world, that one I didn't find on my own, and I didn't even know it was there. I looked around that area, but I mean, I did look down in that area, but it was so tucked away that I didn't find anything there. In fact, once I knew where it was, I still had a really hard time finding it. That's how hard that one was to find. I don't remember the name of it. Hold, like, okay, so what the hell do these spells do? I mean, you need a freaking... I suppose the game probably comes with a book back in these days, you know? An actual physical book that would have information like what the spell hold does, right? It was just easier for them to print a little booklet and send it along with the game, and then the player could reference that for information, an owner's manual, you know? But they don't do that anymore. They haven't done something like that. I don't even remember the last game that I bought that had an owner's manual on it. Oh, I mean, they might have, like, something that's got, like, two sheets, you know, of disclaimers and garbage like that on there, but no actual, like, real substantive information. Like, man... trying to think of the last game that I had that has a big owner's manual. Like, there's some of those games back in the day that would have, I mean, we're talking like a third of an inch thick booklet that came with the video game. Probably an OG Xbox game. I don't know that... I think they were kind of getting rid of those by the time the Xbox 360 was rolled out. Definitely N64. N64 definitely had booklets with the games. That's 100% for sure. And those were pretty detailed. N64. A lot of information in there. phones. Phones used to come with a book. Like, I had an old flip phone that it was a Motorola. I don't remember what model it was. But, they would last me about a year or two before my stuff was wearing a button or the hinge or something was worn out. And I would just go online and buy a used one for like $20. And then this went on for many, many, many years. But that phone came with a booklet that was, dude, I shit you not, it was almost an inch thick. It was like a freaking, I mean, it wasn't a huge book. It was only about the size of like an index card. But it was about an inch thick. And that was the owner's manual and the instruction manual for how to operate that phone. Now imagine if they had something like that for like a modern Note class Galaxy phone, you know? Like, it would be a freaking encyclopedia. It would be huge. I mean, my phone, it was a flagship phone, like, 2018, I suppose. I didn't buy it in 2018. I bought a used one online for, like, I don't know, $400 or $500. It was probably about $400, and then after I bought a case for it, and a screen protector for it, and all that stuff, and it was probably pretty close to $500. But I think I bought this phone used in like 20, actually it was probably, you know, I don't even know, I could probably find out if I just simply check text messages that I sent to myself. If there can't be that many of them, I couldn't scroll through it that fast. Actually, wow, there's a lot more text messages I sent to myself than I realized. I'm proud of you. How did I send that many texts to myself? That's insane, dude. August of 2019 was the first message I sent to myself. And I'm gonna guess I would have done my first test message to myself to make sure that the transfer of phone numbers went the way it was supposed to. So, and that sounds about right, August of 19, I bought this phone, so, what are we, almost August of 22, so I've had this phone for 3 years, but I bought that phone used for about half the cost, less than half the cost, of what it would have cost the previous year, brand new, so it was still... It was last year's model when I bought it used. And even today, it's still better than most of the phones out there floating around. It's a fantastic phone. It's a Galaxy Note 8. The reason I went with that one is the job that I had at the time. I was assigned that phone. And I started working there in February of 2018. So, when I bought this phone for myself, I had been using a Galaxy Note 8 at work very heavily for about a year and a half, and I was really comfortable with it, I liked it, I was used to it, and so I was like, well, I like this phone, so I'm just going to buy one of these. But I didn't want to fork out $1,000 or $1,200 or whatever the hell it was for a brand new one. I was like, no, dude, no, that's too much money. So I went online and I found a pretty good deal on one. At the time, it was a good deal. My brother, he bought one like, I don't know, maybe in the last 12 months for $250, brand new. Brand new, never opened box. I don't know where he found that, but I think he got it on eBay, actually. That's a hell of a deal, because that phone is a... I would recommend that phone to anybody. It's a very, very good phone. In fact, the processor on this phone is stronger than the processor on my computer. And my computer is decent. It's, when I'm just talking about how much RAM it has. I think my computer, and it's not a fancy computer. It's not that good. It's got a i5, i-core, or whatever it's called, Pentium i5, I think, processor. So, I mean, it's... You know, a few years ago, it was better than it is now, but it's getting kind of old. But I think I've only got 8 gigabytes of RAM on that thing, and my phone has 16 gigabytes of RAM. Now, I don't do anything super crazy as far as, like, gaming on my computer. I use my Xbox for that stuff. But I can play older games on it. Like, I can run, like, a PlayStation 2 emulator just fine. I don't think I've tried running a PS3 emulator on it, but I feel confident that they could run that. Chest, I don't get that chest. Anyway, it's a solid phone, and I would recommend it to anyone. So the main reason I had put off buying a more modern phone for so long was because when I've used phones in the past, I hate trying to type and stuff with my fat finger and stuff. So I was always just like, well, if it doesn't have a stylus, I don't want it. And these Note Class phones, they have a stylus called an S Pen built right into them. They're fantastic. Absolutely awesome. I use that thing constantly. And so having used it for like a year and a half for work, I was like sold on that phone. So I don't know. I don't really have any interest in... I mean, I guess if I've never used an iPhone... like with any kind of frequency. I mean, I've used iStuff. My mom's got an iPhone and I kind of looked at hers a little bit, just kind of played around a little bit, but unless they introduce an iPhone that has a stylus built into it, just like these Galaxy Note Class phones, I just don't really have any interest in that shit. But I did hear rumors that they were going to start they're going to start putting styluses into the big iPhones. And I don't have any interest in buying a new phone anytime soon if I don't have to. Like I said, I have no complaints with this thing. It's been fantastic for me. I did change the battery out. The Interstate Battery Store locally here does that kind of work, and they got a guy there that's really, really knowledgeable. They don't even charge labor for that shit, which is really cool. But I knew the guy, so I just, you know, I ordered a battery online and brought it in there and just put it in there for me. I'm kind of like, I think about, you know, like, why the hell this guy, because the guy that does the work there for them, like that, like, changes the batteries off the phones and stuff, he is really, really, really skilled with a lot of different things, and I think to myself, like, why the hell does he even work there, man? Because there's, like, he could go into business for himself, he could, I mean, and then, you know, I find myself realizing, you know, I bet they pay him an ass load of money, dude. The vehicles he drives. I've not been to his house before, but I know the neighborhood he lives in. It's a brand new freaking house. So, that tells me, you know, when guy's driving the kind of vehicles he drives and lives in the neighborhood he lives. Unless his wife has a lot of money, they're paying him a lot of money. I mean, the guy's been there for like 20 years, so, you know, I'm sure he's making around. I would be surprised if he's not pushing six figures, if not higher. I mean, awfully close to that, you know. I know there are people that work there that do make six figures, so I'd be surprised if he's not awfully close to it. Damn that man. But you know, I've never stayed anywhere. You know, the longest I've ever stayed at any job is 5 years, and that wasn't consecutively. You know, I left and came back. I started at this hotel, I worked there for a year, and then a position opened up that I applied for, and they gave the job to somebody else. I wasn't really butthurt about it or anything, but the guy that got the job became my new boss, and I didn't really care for him on a personal level. I thought he was unprofessional, and I didn't care for, you know, everybody, I'm not going to say, you know, people can't live their life how they want, but I didn't agree with a lot of his lifestyle choices. I just didn't think that it was the healthy way to live your life, and I just didn't feel comfortable working for this guy, so I just resigned. And then it wasn't very long until he left to go work for a sister company. The company that I worked for, at the time they owned three of the hotels in the town or the region that I live in, and I don't know how he got the job. I don't know if he was offered it or if he applied for it or what the deal was, but he left the position that I had applied for to go work in one of the sister companies at a, it would have definitely been a pay upgrade, because he would have gone from the front of house manager of one department at the hotel I worked at to go become the, well, he would have been a department head. But he would have had a little bit bigger department, and probably a better bonus structure. So he left to go to the other hotel, and then the hotel that I've been working at, like, the main boss there wanted, my brother was actually working there still, because I got him a job there while I was working there. My brother was like, well, you know, they want you to come back, but, you know, and I was like, well, I'll go in and talk to him or whatever. And so, I came back on a part-time basis, and I was cool with that. And ironically, I ended up going to work at the other hotel, the same one the guy that I didn't care for transferred to, but we were in different departments. So, like, I mean, I would see him, you know, and I wasn't like I hated the guy or anything, you know. I was friendly to him and everything. We got along on a, you know, professional level. I just didn't care for him personally. And since I was not his subordinate, it didn't bother me. I could work at the same place as the guy. I just didn't want to be a subordinate to him. I mean, I respected some of the things about him, and, you know, some of the, he was good at some things, you know. I just, he was really unprofessional when it came to a number of different things, and I just was like, dude, no, I'm not gonna work for you. I can work at the same place as you, but I'm not gonna work for you. Sorry, bro. So then after I came back, then, you know, I was there for like 6 or 8 or 9 months, and then that same position that I'd applied for a year back opened up again. I applied for it again, and then I got it. And then I was at a department head for them for like 2.5 years. I think that's about right, 2.5, 3.5. I don't know, I'd have to look at it, but I guess I first started there in November of 2011, and then I left in December of 2012, and then I came back in, like, I don't know, September of 2012, and then I would have, was it really 14? I was thinking it was longer than that. But maybe it wasn't. So 2013. It would have been 13. Because I left in November or December of 12. So I came back in like August of 13. And then it was 14. And then in May of 14 is when I was promoted. And then I left in August of 16. So I guess it wasn't quite 2.5 years. But I started there in 2011, November of 11. I left there in August of 16. So that frame of time is almost 5 years. 3 years shy, or 3 months shy of 5 years. Plus, I did leave though for like 9 months in there. So if you add the 9 plus 3, there's really only about 4 years that I worked there. And that's about right. Nothing in my life lasts more than 4 years. Well, except for, like, possessions. There are some things that I own that I've had for decades. Wait, can I get up there? Well, let's see what's this. Okay. Well, this is a save point. Okay, alright, cool, you got a tent? Awesome, bro. But yeah, but 4 years is just about as long as anything lasts in my life. Jobs. I've never had a job that really, I mean, other than that hotel job, which I guess technically, if you add up all the months that I worked there, really would add up to only about 4 years. And there's been a few other jobs that I liked that I lasted 4 years. There were two different pizza joints that I worked at for 4 years. The one, I would have stayed there. It's interesting when I think back at that period of my life. I got charged with a DUI that never even stuck. I kind of got hosed on that one, man. That was some bullshit. But as a result, I resigned from my job and I went and did something else. But I liked my job. I liked the people I worked with. I liked my job. I would not have left willfully at that point in my life. No way. So, actually, I'm gonna end my stream here. I'm awfully tired. Didn't we save right there? Maybe we didn't. I'm gonna end this fight here, and I'm gonna go back in that place and make sure I save. And then I'm gonna end the stream. But I don't know how long I would have stayed there if I hadn't gotten that car accident and I lost my license. Shit. Who knows how long I would have worked there? There's one guy that I know that was working there still in 2017. Yeah, 2017. So he'd been working there since, well, he wasn't working there when I started, so he started there sometime while I was there, which would have been like 2000. When I started there in 2001, he probably started in like 2002 or 2003. So like, let's say it was 2002. That's 12 is 10 years. So 15 years he'd been there. And I don't know if I would have stayed there for 15 years or not. I guess I really don't know. There's a really good chance that I would have stayed there until such time that I was offered a position that I would have made more money. And that I liked, because I liked my job. The hours were good. The pay was solid. I mean, you gotta imagine, this was back in like 20. Well, I started in 2000, 2001. And I was averaging, like, I don't know. Well, like probably like $15 an hour, and that's like 2001, right? When gas was 99 cents a gallon. So you have to figure, a Big Mac extra value meal was probably, dude, like probably less than $4, no more than $5. It was probably like $4 back then. It might have still been $2.99. I don't remember. It was probably more than $3, but it was probably less than $4. I'm trying to think what other things cost back then. Pack of cigarettes. Man, dude, a pack of cigarettes was probably. You could probably get a carton of Camels for like $20. Maybe less than that. Probably less on sale. So, You know, a gallon of gas is a dollar. A carton of Camels, 20 bucks or less. You know, $15 an hour for a early 20s kid is not a bad deal in those days. Do you account for inflation? You know, I was doing well, all things considered. For my age, and for the work I was doing. I like that job. Good times. Anyway, thank you for your time. You guys all have a wonderful rest of your night, and I'll see you when I see you.